Alamance County is pleased to present the Alamance County Commissioners Meeting.
Commissioner Linda Massey to offer our prayer and lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance.
Bow our heads, please. Lord, we thank you for this day. We thank you for the privilege of being commissioners here, and we just ask that you give us the strength and the wisdom to carry out the business of Alamance County. Amen.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, Linda. Good morning, everyone. We'll call this the first December 2013 meeting, Alamance Board of Commissioners to order. Welcome to all of you. Thank you for being with us this morning. First item on the agenda is to hear public comments. We have three this morning. I'd like to call, I think it's Mr. Luke, is it Mr. Allen?
Yes.
Come forward, please. Welcome. Would like to talk about building safety.
Yes.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning. This, about the weapons ban that somebody proposed for the county. If you put a sticker out there, you're just going to keep law-abiding citizens carrying weapons. County building. Stickers not going to keep the criminals from carrying weapons. Not going to make the building any safer. As a matter of fact, the statement the sheriff council made about having $50,000 or $60,000 over here in this building will make the building even more unsafe. Criminals are sure, certainly watching the outcome of this meeting. I would not be a criminal. If he passed resolution banning all guns would be the first place I'd hit. I remember a lot of great people in here like me, and I don't mean that derogatory, but you probably remember the whites only signs. I was seeing them on the county office door down here. Same constitution. I remember the race riots we had in the 60s. Can't put a whites only sign there. Why? But the Constitution of the United States guarantees that we are going to be treated fairly. The Second Amendment right was second to the First Amendment right, which is free speech. Why was it second? Well, was that anyway? The sheriff's last statement in Alamance News, the last paragraph said, y'all passed this resolution that he could somehow give a special permit out to who he wanted to carry a permit in this building or any other county building. You can't do that. I hope you know that. Thank you
for your time. Thank you, Mr. Allen. Our next speaker is Mr. Tony Cox. We'd like to speak on the history. Good morning to you.
Are we working?
Are we sure we're working?
Testing. How many weeks in a row is that? Or how many meetings in a row? October, human error, video missing. Couldn't get in downstairs the last meeting. This. I bring my own recording device. Constitution of the United States of America. The government don't work. Look all over the world. The government don't work. And you know, I looked at this ordinance, and let me make it clear again, I ain't no lawyer. I'm just an American. But I don't see how it is that the North Carolina State Bar would allow a lawyer, y'all's a law here, Alamance County, our lawyers, y'all's lawyers, I don't know, to propose something like that with an open-ended penalty, whatever the law, you know, I don't know. It's amazing. Thug rule don't work. Why do y'all want to be thugs? Want to be thugs? The deaths has come from the tax department. They stealing the money. It ain't us. They ain't got to worry about us. Government don't have to worry about the people. Do your job and follow the law. That's all they got to do. And it's y'all's job to make them or get them out. I don't understand this. You know, it's funny. They said in the tax department they had a problem because two citizens, walked into the tax office with a gun. But look at the crimes that's being committed against us, the people. Why can't we get help? We can get rid of thugs in government, and we can bring this country back to what's supposed to be the Constitution. Does anybody want anybody other than a lawman coming and charging them with a crime? Do you? This is America. I love it. I'm free to run my mouth. And I'm going to. I tell everybody. All you got to do is do the job and follow the law. That's all it is. It's simple. If we can do it, y'all can do it. If y'all going to do like y'all do to us, when we mess up, do it to them. Why are they better? And it don't get better, it just keeps getting worse. I don't understand it. And I know I've been over 3 minutes. I know I have. But hey, I love y'all. Y'all are my elected officials. I mean no harm to nobody whatsoever. But we want y'all to protect us. Our sheriff, he tries the best he can. Can you imagine dealing with the people over there with all the testosterone at the sheriff's department and egos? And the funny thing is, please let me keep talking.
Thank you, Mr. Cox. Appreciate your comments. Our last speaker this morning is Mr. Joe Allen. Mr. Allen wants to talk about building safety. Mr. Allen, good morning to you, sir. Welcome.
How are you doing? Good morning. I am one of the incidents. I am the guy that came in and paid his taxes with my gun on my hip. This morning, my gun is in my car. So now I have to worry about somebody taking my firearm out of my vehicle and conducting crime with it. The law-abiding citizens should be allowed to carry their firearms. I go anywhere else in Alamance County with my gun on my hip. I go to Walmart, I go shopping. We don't have any problems. No SWAT teams sitting out in the parking lot when I come out. Everybody's fine. I don't understand why the law-abiding citizens are getting categorized with criminals. I don't understand that. No criminal's going to walk around with his gun on his hip. Y'all know that. He's going to have it where? It's going to be stuck in his waistband. Sticker's not going to stop him. He's going to do what he wants to do anyway. It's against the law to rob banks, right? They rob them every day, correct? So that's what I don't understand. A law-abiding citizen, I mean, that's my constitutional right. I don't know why y'all think you're going to infringe on it like that. I don't, just to protect who? That little girl down there in the county office? Nobody's threatening her. I'm the guy that somebody generated an email about, said that I was irate and threatening with my gun. No, I wasn't. I came in, I paid $400 on my taxes. I could have paid 10. So I can't be mad at nobody but myself. Their taxes I owe, I've been paying them. Paid them ever since I lived in Alamance County. So that's not a problem. When's the last time y'all had a gun issue? Somebody whipped a gun out and got mad about taxes in the tax office since it exists. When? You have it. So why now? Why take away my right? The right that my people went and fought for. How many people dying right now to fight for our rights? Yours too. They're dying every day over there. And then you're going to do what? Take it away? They die in vain? It doesn't make any sense. I proposed to somebody that we take and move your metal detectors over to that door, take your deputy off the stool, and set him in behind that little covert right there in the foyer. You got how many sheriffs you got downstairs now? Huh? You got what, three? He's sitting over on a stool in the other building. Took him 25 minutes to get to the tax administrator's office when we were there. Set him in that little foyer right there. Put your metal detector on this side. Let the law-abiding citizen come in those doors and make a left and go by your deputy. And go in there to the tax office. Let the tax girl have her deputy in the foyer and feel safer. If that's what you want to do. But don't take my rights away because she's scared of her job. I mean, the girls at Walmart, they don't quit every time I go in there and go grocery shopping. They don't quit. They're there the next day. Yeah, I go in a bank. You talk about $50,000, $60,000. How much money has Bank of America got? I bank there three times a week. I walk in there with my gun. They're happy to see me. They greet me at the door. Hey, Mr. Allen, how you doing? I mean, nobody's scared. Nobody ducks and dives behind the teller wall or none of that. So I just don't understand what the big deal is. How many times I come to the tax office? Once or twice a year? And I am the incident. Y'all keep mentioning the incident. I'm one of them. That was me. I come in before and I come in after. And so I don't understand how threatening am I. How much more threatening would I be if I had my pistol on my hip to y'all right now? None.
Thank you, Mr. Allen.
Thank you.
I like your shirt, Joe. I like the back of that shirt.
Thank you, sir.
This concludes the public comments. Are there any commissioner responses at this time?
I think we've all got a lot to say, but you know, I don't know why this is at the tail end of the agenda. You know, if we'd had a heck of a crowd here, which I'm disappointed in. I'm disappointed in that. Very disappointed. But this discussion is at the end, so if everybody wants to wait to the end of it, that's fine with me. I'd like to get it over with, but there's a lot to be said.
Any other responses at this time? If not, item 4 is the approval of the agenda. Commissioners, if we can take just a minute and review the agenda, including the consent agenda. Mr. Honeycutt, do you have any changes to the agenda this morning?
There will be a budget amendment for the library that was in a burden that left off of the agenda. It's a community development grant, no county dollars, but I'll do that under county manager's update.
All right, so that'll be in addition to item 9?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Commissioners, are there any items on the consent agenda that you would like removed for discussion? Hearing none, no other changes to the agenda, we'll entertain a motion to approve the agenda, including those items on consent.
So moved.
Second.
Thank you, Linda. Bill, any other discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? The agenda is approved and the consent agenda items have been approved. It's now time for item number 6, and I am going to ask County Manager Craig Honeycutt if he will handle item 6, which is the board organization. Mr. Honeycutt?
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. At this time, we are setting the chairman for the upcoming year. This will be for the 2014 fiscal year, or 2014 year. Is there a motion for chairman?
I motion that we appoint David Smith as chairman.
There's a motion. Is there a second?
Second.
Motion and second. Any other discussion on this item? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed? Motion passes.
Point of order. Was there a no vote?
I didn't vote.
Okay. That is recorded as a yes vote?
Mm-hmm. Yes. Next is the election of a vice chairman.
Mr. Honeycutt, if I may take a matter of privilege and ask Mr. Smith if he would like to sit here since we're completed item A and let him act as chairman for this meeting, I would be privileged and honored to do so. Mr. Smith, you will come here.
And get your coat.
Put mine down there?
Yeah.
Thank you, Mr. Honeycutt.
Hey, Mr. Chair, I'll let you run from here.
Oh, okay. Thank the board for your vote, and I'm sure that we will be able to work together for the next year, and we'll all do everything possible that we can to for the betterment of Alamance County, and that's the main thing. That's our main objective, I think, on this board, is what's best for the county. And we may not always agree, but we can debate, we can discuss, vote, and make our decisions. Again, thank you, board members. The floor is now open for a nomination for vice chairman.
Mr. Chair, I'd like to nominate Bill Ashley to that office, please.
Bill Ashley's been nominated. I'll second that nomination. Any further nomination? Any further discussion? All in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye. Aye. Aye.
Mr. Vice Chairman. Aye. Next item on the agenda is the adoption of a resolution to set regular meeting schedule for 2014. Mr. Honeycutt, you have that?
Yes, sir. That is in your agenda packet. It follows the same meeting schedules we've had this year.
Do I hear a motion?
So moved.
Second?
Second.
Been moved and seconded. All in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye. Aye.
Motion passes. Next item, designation of voting delegate for all 2014 NCACC conferences and meetings.
Mr. Chairman, I'd like to nominate Linda Massey to continue in that role. I think she's been very effective in carrying our message to the state and getting information back from the state.
Motion on the floor. Is there a second?
Second.
Any discussion? All in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye. Aye.
Linda? The next item is approval of bonds for public officials. Mr. Honeycutt.
These are our normal bonds that need to be approved on an annual basis, and they do meet the statutory requirements as required.
It is. Do I hear a motion?
So moved.
May I ask a question? I asked this last year. Are these maximum bonds that we can put out there?
They're minimum required by statute.
Are there any that you feel like should be increased due to liability?
They're indemnification bonds. If the county is sued, if any of these officers are sued, the bond company steps in and then turns around and the county pays the bond company.
I mean, do they need to be increased at any level?
I would suggest that they be lowered, but
lowered,
that's,
right. Oh, that's what
just my suggestion.
But this is a statutory minimum.
Okay. Right.
Any further discussion? Has there been a second?
I'll second.
Any further discussion? All in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Mm-hmm. All right. Now, if the board will permit, I would like to put number 8 before number 7. I think we have quite a few people here on that particular item. Is it all right?
Yeah.
With the board?
Yeah.
I'm fine.
I think it's a good idea.
That item is discussion of proposed ordinance prohibiting carrying deadly weapons in Alamance County government buildings. Any discussion by the board at this time? I think most of you have a copy of it in the packet. Is that correct?
Mm-hmm.
Mr. County Attorney, do you want to present that?
Be glad to.
Good morning.
Mr. Chairman and members of the board, the sheriff at our last meeting gave a report regarding public safety in the county buildings, and the board asked me to draft the ordinance, which I did and presented to you for your review. And there are several exemptions in the ordinance in section 4, one of which allows the sheriff to consider people that want to carry their weapons in county buildings. The sheriff can be the gatekeeper for that, and this makes, in my view, it makes sense since he is the one that can do background checks on people. If you're going to carry a weapon in the county building, since it's the law has been changed, people can inherit handguns. You don't know the background of that person that's carrying that handgun. And it seems to me that the sheriff is the gatekeeper for public safety, and he should be the one that makes that decision. So that's why I put that exemption F in there. I sent the board a memorandum of law detailing the U.S. Constitution and state constitution, and I also gave you copies of other local government ordinances that prohibit carrying open carry and concealed carry in buildings. So I'll be happy to try and answer any questions you have.
Any questions for county attorney?
I've got a lot I want to talk about. Do it now or while he's there, it doesn't matter to me.
Let's discuss then. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, Mr.
McClain. Appreciate it.
On an immediate comment, you know, Clyde Albright mentioned that to me, that the sheriff could write a note, and I'm basically going to maybe paraphrase what I told him. You know, that's a joke. The law is already there for concealed carry. That's the note. That's the paper. And the Founding Fathers wrote the most important note ever to be written, the Constitution. We don't need a note for law-abiding citizens to do what the government's already said is allowable, and or what can be changed, which I hope we'll do this morning on something. What's happening are knee-jerk reactions to what has taken place in Raleigh. And it's political. It's partisan, and it's political, meshed together. You had a law in Raleigh that was passed. What was the number of that law, House Bill 937? Is that it? Now, I asked for this to be. Yeah, House Bill 937, and it was voted right down party line. If you look at the registration of the representatives that voted for that or against that, and that was, I think, facilitating better acceptance of concealed carry in society. It was right down party lines. Democrats opposed it. Republicans were in favor of it. Right down, I don't think there was more than one or two crossover votes from what I was told by the clerk's office in Raleigh. This very morning, Person County is doing the same thing we're doing. And there's countless challenges all over the state about concealed carry in parks. Again, Person County's voting on this morning. This morning was their second reading. It's politics. When I first found out that this was coming to light, I begged Craig Honeycutt, and you know I did, to think this through. And if you did, I don't think you thought far enough. Jeremy Akins, is that his last name?
Yes, sir.
He told me last week that when he wrote the email, which we didn't get a copy of until I requested a copy of it, he sent an email to the sheriff, to Craig, and to Clyde Albright, that people had come in the tax office armed, and they were disturbed by it. Same issue, Person County. Told me that after he did the email, he didn't realize after he'd done the email that they hadn't broken any laws. Isn't that amazing? I mean, that's stunning to me. And, you know, I don't like to make notes of what I want to talk about, but I'll try to keep it brief. But our country is falling apart. You see on TV where people are coming up to you on the sidewalk, just bam, right behind, knockout. It's a game called knockout. Because there's no fear.
I think that only happens in the north.
I tell my son to watch out for it here and everywhere he goes. And I watch out for it. But the bottom line is your country is falling apart. I think you have law enforcement agencies that are in fear of the public having guns to a big degree. You have law enforcement people that have told me recently they think you ought to submit to a search of your car without a warrant. You know, the quote to me by the police, I'm not ashamed to say it, by the police chief of Burlington, not Sheriff Johnson, but the police chief of Burlington told me that if you have nothing to hide, you ought to submit to having your car searched. And I said, are you kidding me? That's exactly what he told me. They believe in sitting on street corners, watching certain establishments, while they let the elitist establishments, where there's just as much violation of the laws, go unchecked, because they know they'll catch heck if they sit outside the country club, if they sit outside other establishments. But boy, they'll sit outside a local bar and then tailgate you for a mile praying that you screw up and then pull you. I am stunned at what I'm seeing in this nation. And I had more to say. I'm just frustrated at the whole situation. Concealed carry law that we have, I want to make a motion that we do away with that. It was done in 1995, October of 95. I signed it. I'm not going to lie to you. Junior signed it, Larry, me, John. I don't know who the other one was.
Moorefield.
Yeah, Ricky Moorefield. Lord, does it go that far back? Yeah, I hadn't been on the board but about a year. And there was no debate.
I thought you were born on this board.
You were. But I signed it. Sure, I signed it because there wasn't much debate back then about this issue. But I would rather have a concealed carry than anything because they've gone through the training, they've gone through the classes, and I think I'm going to get me a concealed carry after all this. I'm more passionate than people think about guns. I own them. But by George, our freedom was won at the end of one. And people never, ever better forget that. And I believe in order for us to keep our freedom, it'll be at the end of one if things don't get better. My son has had a gun held to his head in the city of Burlington on his temple and robbed. We found out who it was. One's in jail now over it. But that's when he bought his first pistol. There's a paranoia about guns in America. People that don't like them just, Thank God our founding fathers didn't feel that way. And our militias. And our military. Thank God they don't feel that way. So I'm not going to support this ordinance, and I would like to make a motion after this is over with to repeal what we've already got on the books that we did in 1995 and allow concealed carry in the building. Now, you've got counties that have done the complete opposite. And I'm not going to lie to you. I'll tell you, you didn't seem to find anybody that had different rules. But I did on the second phone call. Randolph County. Now, on the first phone call, the first phone call was to Davidson County. Davidson County has no rules at all because I was told that their county commissioners went in closed session years ago and said there was no proof at all that having these rules made anybody any safer. Now, on the second phone call, that was the first phone call. The second phone call was Randolph County. Yes, they've banned everything. So I'm not going to sit up here and say nobody's not done this. I expect Person County is going to do the same thing this morning. You got 4 out of 5 Democrats on their board and a Democrat sheriff. And I'll still say it's partisan. It's political. But I'm not going to vote to ban what law-abiding citizens have the right to do. Matter of fact, I think we should be able to make it easier for them. And I'm sorry if I belabored it, and there's a lot of things I want to say. That wasn't all. Maybe I'll think of it later. I'll shut up.
I have a gun, by the way.
Good for you. Any further discussion on this issue?
Well, I think I support the concealed carry. I have a concealed carry, and I think the safest that we're going to ever be is when we got concealed carry permits and that people have that controlled Well, they've gun in their pocket. You know, that's when you're safe, when everybody in the room don't know who's got a gun. And I think the people who have concealed carry are the safest people there are to have in your presence. So I'm going to support Tim Sutton's motion.
Well, let's get this issue settled first that is on the agenda. Is there any further discussion concerning the proposed ordinance, which has not been introduced, it's just been proposed? Any other question? Is there a motion? Hearing no motion, the issue is dead. Now, Tim, I think you have a
a motion you want to make?
Yes, sir. I thought I'd already made it, but you know, formally I will make it. You know, it doesn't make sense. It does. The logic doesn't flow. The continuity doesn't flow. That if you're going to say it's okay for open carry, it's illegal to be not, you know, to not be allowed to carry concealed carry. It doesn't flow. Due to the training that's required, the classes that are required, the sheriff's handling of it personally, more personally than maybe the other, it doesn't flow to allow one and then ban the other. So that's I want the laws to be in a continuity fashion, and it is, and law should flow. And so I make a motion to repeal, if that's the right word, the 1995 ordinance that I signed. I'm not going to sit up here and say I didn't sign it. I did sign it. Didn't know any better. But I do now. And that we repeal that ordinance.
Motion on the floor.
I'll second that.
Motion and a second. Any further discussion on the issue from the board? All in favor of the motion to repeal the ordinance signed the second day of October 1995, ordering the posting of signs to prohibit the carrying of concealed handguns on county property. This motion is to repeal that ordinance. Please signify by saying aye.
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 Any opposed? Motion carries. Next, the item on the agenda is the annual comprehensive financial report. Is Roberts from Martin Starnes and Associates, please come on down.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman and Board of Commissioners, for having me today. My name is Crystal Roberts. I'm from Martin Starnes and Associates, and we prepare your annual financial statements. First of all, we issued an unqualified opinion on your 2013 financial statements. Excuse me, unmodified opinion. Unmodified opinion is new language this year due to the implementation of GASB 63 and 65. Unmodified opinion means that you have a clean report with no material misstatements and no findings. Here's your general fund summary. You can see that your revenues came in at $123 million. Your expenditures came in at $121 million. These revenues and expenditures do not include capital lease proceeds, and they do not include any transfers in from other funds. In comparison to 2012, you can see your revenues decreased by $100,000 and your expenditures decreased by $3 million. So from a revenue to an expense standpoint, you increased fund balance by $2 million. But then you can see here on my next slide that your total fund balance actually increased by $4.6 million. The $4.6 million increase represents the capital lease proceeds of around $1 million and the transfer in from the school lottery funds of $1.9 million. So your total fund balance came in at $26.3 million. Available fund balance is the calculation that the Local Government Commission uses to gauge your county in comparison to others of your size. You take total fund balance minus non-spendable and minus stabilization by state statute. And here are those numbers for fiscal year 13. You can see that your available fund balance is $20 million, and that number is important because it represents the amount that the county can appropriate in fiscal year 14. However, not included in that $20 million is around $2.3 million of internal and external restrictions that the county has to consider. So your total unrestricted fund balance is $17.3 million. Your unrestricted fund balance in 2012 was $14 million. So there was an increase there. The Local Government Commission takes your available fund balance and it divides it by your general fund expenditures and transfers out to come up with a percentage. And your percentage was 16.4. in 2013, so that was a 5% increase over prior year.
Can I ask a question now, or do you
sure.
want questions at the end? That screen right there, can you tell everyone the statutory minimum when the Local Government Commission sends us letters of attention and where we are in relation to that based on what happened last year?
Yes, sir. There's no state law that sets a minimum, but the local government commission uses an 8% minimum as a benchmark, and that represents 1 month's worth of your expenditures. And so last year, the county was at 11.2%, and as you approach the 8%, the local government commission will give you a heads up. And then also, sometimes the local government commission will pull out your designations. And I believe last year when they pulled out those designations, you actually dropped a little below the 8%.
What is that now?
The 16.4 minus your designations, I believe you would come in around 14%.
So we won't be getting a letter?
Well, you know, they don't only rely on the 8% mark. They also look at your fund balance in comparison to others of your size.
So the 14% is what we, as opposed to the 7.86 last
yes.
year, is that correct?
Yes. And it might be a little around 13.5.
But we basically doubled the percentage.
Correct. And then my last slide here is your other major enterprise fund, your landfill fund. You can see that your income came in at 1.17, that's after all operating expenditures and revenues, and your total net position came in at 20 million. Net position is also new terminology in 2013, again to new accounting standards. Last year the terminology was net assets, and for an enterprise fund that means fund balance. So your total fund balance for your landfill came in at $20 million. Are there any other questions?
How did our fund balance, that's, you know, increased to 16, right?
Yes.
Compare with our peer counties or the county?
You know, I can get you that information and I can email it to you. The State Treasurer's Department does post that on their website, but there's always a year lag.
Yeah.
And so right now, if I were to go out and get that information for you, you would still be graded on your 11% last year,
right,
because
right,
2012
right.
is posted. Results usually come out around February or March, but I can send that information as soon as it comes out.
And you know, there's a whole lot of things to look at. We've discussed this before. You've got a lot of counties, some counties, and I could name them, that have tremendous fund balances because they go through reevaluation, not cut property tax, not go to revenue neutral, so forth and so on. I mean, it's... I don't know if you look at any of that play or not, but you know, there's a county that has like a 20-some percent fund balance. It's definitely a sister or brother county of ours, and you know, I mentioned it a while ago, but the reason their fund balance is so blasted high, they went through reevaluation after 8 years and didn't cut property tax a penny. Not a penny. And but our 10, I think Wake was at 10, and you know, there's some very, very credible counties that, you know, financially, as far as their stability, that doesn't have tremendous fund balances. Not that I object to ours, but I hope you can look at that analysis.
And the actual report will be ready when?
Your report has been submitted to the local government commission, but they're still holding on to it in their review process, so we're waiting their approval. So as soon as we get their approval, I'll send it over to finance, and they'll upload it on your website and issue the final copies. But we do not anticipate any number changes as a result of the LGC review.
Any other questions?
Yeah, Mr. Chairman, I'd just like to offer a few words of congratulation, if I may, to this board for overseeing the budget process the year before, and as we worked into last year. It was a very difficult budget and planning year. I'd like to recognize and thank Craig and Brian and Amy and everybody that was involved in the budgeting process. I know Greg's in the next room. Certainly his management of the landfill and the landfill enterprise fund is exemplary. So I just want to let everybody know that I appreciate everybody's work on doing this. You know, revenue stayed the same. We cut expenses by $3 million, but we were able to provide additions to certain departments and provide the things I think that we needed to do. The other thing I'd just like to add and mention, given the favorable percentage of our fund balance as of, I guess that'd be June 30th, 2013, and given what we budgeted last spring about longevity pay for county employees, I would like to make a motion that we reinstate the original formula for longevity pay for this period ending 2000.
Tom, could we hold that until Ms. Roberts is finished? And
well,
I'll turn it over to you.
Well, I'd be fine.
Anything else for Ms. Roberts? Thank you very much.
Thank you for having me. Have a good day.
Okay, Tom.
All right. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Just given that this board approved the budget for 2014 that it initially included the longevity formula based on previous patterns and was changed late in the summer, which I did not support at the time. I still don't support it. My motion is that we reinstate that for this fiscal year, which would allow the payment to be made at this time, with the understanding that during budget cycle that comes up this spring of 2014, we revisit the whole formula of longevity, the practice, the formula, the eligibility, and so forth, to make possible adjustments at that time. So my motion is to reinstate longevity pay through the original formula that was approved by this board in the spring.
And that would take it, if approved, back up to what, $1 million at $900,000?
Yeah. We capped it at $500,000.
Yeah, so it would, in essence, be an appropriation, a further appropriation of $500,000, right?
A little over $500,000.
Yeah, so. I won't support that.
Motion on the floor. Do I hear a second?
I'll second it.
Motion and a second. Any further discussion on the motion? Hearing none. All in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed?
No.
No. Motion fails 2-3.
Sorry, employees.
Next item on the agenda is the county manager's report, which includes the budget amendment.
Greg? Yes, sir. Thank you, Mr. Chairman, and also congratulations on that appointment. In front of you, you do have budget amendment number 43, which is basically a transfer of revenue in from the community development block grant from the city of Burlington for the North Park Community Library in the amount of $16,237. And MJ is here if there's any questions.
There's a budget amendment been proposed. Do I hear a motion?
So moved.
Second.
Any discussion? All in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed? Motion passes.
Mr. Chairman, a couple dates to make you aware of. The Public Officials Breakfast with ACC is scheduled for this Wednesday at 7:30.
What time was that again?
7:30 at ACC.
A.M.?
Yeah, yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Breakfast.
That's not 5 o'clock, Dave. You can get to that. You can get there. Tell everybody the story about 5 o'clock.
Well, no, I've told Bill the story about 5 o'clock. At, in the Army, they allowed me to sleep just as late as I wanted to every morning, so long as I was up by 5 o'clock. Right, Marine?
I want you to tell us about the song. It's 5 o'clock somewhere.
Excuse me, Craig. Go ahead.
Oh, no problem. And also to mention that the county Christmas luncheon is scheduled for December 19th starting at 11 a.m. And again, it'll be over at Graham Rec. And also, while I do have you, I was contacted by Marty Lawling with Guilford County last week. He would like to have a joint meeting between the city of Burlington and this board to discuss Project Haystack, the conceptual project that they're looking at the Guilford Prison Farm, and trying to find a time to do that jointly with the city of Burlington. Tim has mentioned that mornings are better, not evenings, or around lunch.
I like to have lunch.
We can have lunch if that is so chosen.
Is this all three boards?
Just two. Burlington and Alamance County.
And the county manager in Guilford's going to...
I think that they have a consultant also that they're working with.
Okay.
Is that group going to be with us also?
I believe so, yes, sir.
So it's more than two boards?
No, no, no. It's just our two boards, but it would be the consultants that they have hired coming to kind of update and with their conceptual ideas of what they would like to see done and what our role may or may not be within the project.
I agree with the lunchtime.
Yeah, something.
Okay. If there's a bad time or a bad day, please let me know, and then we'll get that back to the city of Burlington.
Now, do they want to do this before Christmas, or?
There was a discussion about before Christmas, if possible.
You want to hear from us individually?
Yeah, that'd be great. I'll let Tori know. But we would try to schedule it around a lunch.
Okay. Any questions?
I've got it in the back seat of my car, and I meant to bring it today. The Rhino Times did one heck of a cover story on Haystack, the last issue, and I got five copies sitting in the back of the car for everybody. Y'all.
Good.
I'll bring them to Craig, and Craig can disseminate them. It's quite a expose.
Ms. Chair, I do have one thing. You know, the 18th, I think it's the 18th, that they're going to have the grand opening of the new PTRC.
That's
in
right.
In the Tri-Regional Council. So that would
Kernersville.
Yes. Mm-hmm. In Kernersville, which it's across the road from on 66. Mm-hmm. It's on the left-hand side. So just want to let everybody know that, so you can schedule anything for that day. I think it's a Wednesday, though.
Yes, ma'am. I think it's noon.
Yeah.
Yes, ma'am.
Do you still have the emails I sent you about the Greensboro News and Record articles? There was one Saturday, this past Saturday, and one Friday. On
yes, sir.
That. Okay. Can you forward those
yes,
to
sir.
All the board members?
Yes, sir.
Anything else, Craig?
That's all I have at this time.
Let me make say one thing before we go any further. I'm remiss in not saying it. I want to thank Tom for his leadership on this board, and I think the results of the budget report certainly does indicate that he led the board in doing an outstanding job.
Thank you.
The next item on the agenda is a closed session pursuant to North Carolina General Statute 143-318.11, parenthesis A, in parenthesis, parenthesis 6, in parenthesis, and what does that come out to be, Mr. Attorney? I don't know the numbers.
I'll read it into the record. Pursuant to 143-318.11A6, to consider the performance of an employee.
Okay. Is there a motion that we go into closed session?
So moved.
There's a second.
Second.
All in favor, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Until the board returns.